So if you guys, myself, thought of a great idea that we want to present to Michael that we really think could expand Dunder Mifflin's business. It's a really awesome idea.
I really like this idea. I think Michael's definitely going to go for it. Listen to this.
A horse track.
So?
What do you think, Michael?
Please, no! 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 No!
So Michael definitely did not like the idea. I think he might have overreacted a little bit.
Hey, you suck!
Is this an employee of ours?
Why go, 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 go!
Guys, I think we need to leave Dunder Mifflin if we're going to try to go after this.
No, I agree with you. I think it's our only option, and I really think we could pull it off. What do you think, Rasheed? All right then, it's settled. We're going.
We definitely thought Michael would like the idea, but obviously not. So we decided to start the horse track business on our own. So you guys ready to do this?
Wait. We need a state license for this. You know that, right?
Oh, shoot. That's right. I didn't think about that. We can go get that right now. Let's go. So you guys ready?
I think it's about that time.
All right, let's do it. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My associates and I are here today in hopes of acquiring a license to start a new business that we're hoping to get into. Our business is called Milwaukee County Grounds. Now, Milwaukee County Grounds is a horse racetrack, and we are hoping to open this in the summer of 2017. Now, let me tell you about our mission statement that we want Milwaukee County Grounds to have. Our mission is to provide an old-fashioned form of exciting entertainment to a new audience here in Milwaukee and the surrounding areas. We want the people who attend the races at Milwaukee County Grounds to enjoy wagering on their favorite horse as they compete for the grand prize. We also hope to revitalize the declining industry and raise its popularity here. Now, I'm going to tell you a few goals that our business wants to reach in the early years of its life. Our first goal is to have high standards of cleanliness, comfort, customer service, and a high level of entertainment. We also want to create an enjoyable workplace environment for our employees. We want them to come to work happy to be there. We want it to be a nice place to work and have a job. We also hope to be as competitive as we can be with surrounding casinos and off-track betting venues. We also wish to revitalize the popularity of horse racing tracks, as I stated before in our mission statement. As you may know, the market of horse race tracks has been declining, but we hope to turn that around, hopefully, a little bit here in Milwaukee. One of our final goals is to attract as many people as we can to this racetrack. We want to attract the younger generation while still appealing to the older generation. Now, let me tell you a few things about what our business is going to be about. We're going to follow the normal laws of Wisconsin, obviously. Only 18-year-olds and older can gamble on the horses there, but we will allow all ages to enter the facility. We want this to be as much of a family place as possible. We want to bring in as many people as possible. Now, we are a normal horseback racing track, but we also will be having harness racing to bring in the fans of both styles of racing. Like I said before, we want to bring in as many people as possible to this track. We're also looking into making deals with casinos in the area for off-track betting venues there. Now, I talked earlier about the industry of the horse race tracks going down. I'm going to tell you the other competitors or groups that are in the industry with us. Here in Wisconsin, there are zero other horse racing tracks. So that's a nice thing to think about entering into this market. There are six county fairs that have harness racing tracks, but that's a seasonal thing, and they aren't official horse racing tracks. Another aspect in this industry that we include are lottery ticket games. In Wisconsin, there are 8 official Wisconsin lottery ticket games. Now, the biggest member of this industry will be the casinos. And here in Wisconsin, there are 22 casinos and one right near here in Milwaukee, Potawatomi. Now you're probably wondering, what's the edge that we can get on these other members of the market? But I'll tell you about our competitive advantages that we have here. As I stated, horse racing tracks here in Wisconsin are non-existent. We would be the only one here in this state. The only other possible tracks that you can call it are the county fair tracks that have harness racing. But like I said, those aren't official tracks. Also, another thing about our competitive advantage is that we combine the thrill of the horses racing with the excitement of placing a bet or a wager, which is what the casinos have, but they don't have the racing of the horses and stuff like that. Also, like I said, casinos and lotteries are nearly completely chance, but with the horses, you can take educated bets. You can study up on the horses, learn their past victories, their certain criteria in their training and stuff like that, to make the best bet you can. Also, another competitive advantage of ours is that there is no entrance fee into our lower level stands. They're free to the public. Come in, watch the races. You don't have to bet, but you're encouraged to, obviously. Our upper level stands will have a charge, and also our VIP section up in the second level as well. But this is awesome because a lot of tracks in the US, they charge anywhere you go to the track. But here on our first level, it will be free to the public. Come and enjoy the race, bring your family. It'll be a great atmosphere. Now, one of our final competitive advantages that I want to point out is while most tracks only have one kind of horse racing, either the normal horseback with the jockey or the harness racing. But here at Milwaukee County Grounds, we will have a combination of both. This is a great advantage for us because we not only get to bring in the fans of horseback racing, but also the fans of harness racing. We aren't limited to one pool of racers. The market trend for horse racing tracks has been declining over the past years, and especially over the last 5 years. It's also predicted to continue to decline in the next 5 years, but over a slower rate. We aren't particularly worried about this because, as I stated earlier, we will be the only horse race track here in Wisconsin, and we hope to turn that around. Now I have to include the market trend for casinos because of the gambling relation between casinos and horse race tracks. The market trend for them has been increasing over the years, but it has been slower in the past years. So it's not as threatening as it would have been 5-10 years ago. But it is true that casinos and lotteries do hurt the profitability of horse tracks. But we're hoping, being the only horse race track here in Wisconsin, that will help our profits. Now I'm going to turn it over to Enrique to talk more about the SWOT analysis and other things for our company.
Crushed it. Hello, my name is Enrique Ariello, and I will continue with our presentation with our company's SWOT analysis. So SWOT stands for strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. So we start off with our strengths. Just like my colleague Eric Dorn mentioned, there are no direct horse track competitors in the state of Wisconsin. So that means we'd be entering an untapped market, which in turn means it'd be much easier for us to open up a track here compared to trying to open up a track in a different state. So horse racing enthusiasts would also find it much easier to travel here to watch the latest races, and we will heavily depend on these customers come out to these races as well. The Milwaukee area is very populated, so that means it'd be much easier to attract customers here compared to having to open up a track in an area that isn't, that doesn't have the same demographics as Milwaukee does. Moving on to our weaknesses. So just like Eric Dorn mentioned earlier, the horse racing industry is in decline. So by knowing this information, it is risky for us to enter this market. A market that is in decline and is expected to decline for the next 5 years is more than enough to offset our want to enter this market. And then not enough people are interested in horse racing anymore. The big races like the Triple Crown are the races that gain attention to the horse industry. And then that's where the industry makes most of its revenue. Moving on to O, which stands for our opportunities. Though it may be a failing market, we have a good opportunity to have a positive revenue intake, just because we would be the only track in the state. Now, we also have a chance to revitalize this failing market. We do this by tapping into a market section that isn't necessarily accustomed to attending horse races. Moving on to our last part of the SWOT analysis, T, which stands for our threats. Surprisingly enough, other horse tracks in the U.S. aren't our biggest competitors. Casinos and off-venue betting facilities are our biggest competitors, and they also have the biggest impact on our revenue intake. Casinos, though, are our biggest threat, just because most people are interested in there. They want to gamble their money there. And then most casinos in the U.S. now have actual horse race betting booths in the actual facility itself or on their website. Moving on to my next point, our competition. So I'll be talking about casinos, racinos, and online betting. So casinos. A good example of this would be Potawatomi. Potawatomi is the most visited casino in the Milwaukee area. It provides a hotel service, so a lot of people find themselves there every other weekend maybe. So Potawatomi also offers a horse racing betting booth in the facility, and on the website itself, you can also bet there. Moving on to racinos. Racinos are horse tracks and casinos combined. So people get the luxury of enjoying a horse track and then gambling the money there at the casino. A good example of this would be Delaware racetrack in Delaware itself. Then moving on to online betting. This is probably the second biggest competitor to our horse racing industry. TVG.com is probably the most known online betting source where people there find it easy to access, easy to gamble their money, and easy to make their money. Moving on to my final point, our company analysis. So I'll be talking about potentiality, new entertainment, and new jobs. So my first point, potentiality. Horse racing has always been a great experience to all ages, but not all racetracks are readily accessible. There isn't one single famous racetrack in the state of Wisconsin, and Southeast Wisconsin shows good promise for a racetrack to be open here. Moving on to my next point, new entertainment. The Milwaukee area is in need of a new form of entertainment that will appeal to all ages and not just a specific group of people. Children will enjoy the horses, the adults will enjoy the thrill of betting, and the elderly will enjoy that old great experience they knew so well. Moving on to my last point, new jobs. The construction of a new racetrack will bring many jobs. And then the jobs that would vary within the new racetrack would be vending and full-time positions at the actual racetrack itself. Next, I'll talk about the target market. I want to talk about the geographic segment, the demographic segment, and what kind of target strategy we're introducing. So to start off with the geographic segment, we're going to target the Milwaukee area because it provides a big source of people. And then we're in our demographic segments, we're going to target 18-year-olds and older because they have the ability to gamble on the horses. And we'll also target households of any income. We're going to target these segments because they have substantial size, and these segments would be most profitable because of the sizes. I mean, and then the type of strategy we'd use for targeting would be differentiated, because we want to be able to appeal to younger generations as well as older generations. And now my colleague Rasheed will continue this presentation.
With Milwaukee County Grounds, I first would like to start off with the products and services that we would offer, including live horse races, responsible gambling, food, concessions, VIP restaurant, and various other forms of entertainment. As for our prices, we would have free admission for our lower level. As for our second level prices, we would use a competitor orientation pricing strategy with adults starting at $3,
adults over the age of 60, a $1 fee. Children would be free, and then we'd have premium pricing for our VIP members. The primary revenue center for the business will come from the ongoing sales of tickets, as well as a gambling revenue from the people placing bets on the horse races at the racetrack. The secondary revenue stream for the business will come from the ongoing sales of concessions as it relates to the event that are held at the racetrack facility. This revenue center will ensure that the business remains profitable, cash flow positive at all times. As for our marketing and promotion strategies, we intend to use a qualified advertising and marketing firm to help the horse track reach its intended audience of people living in the company's targeted market. This campaign will include the use of traditional print and media advertising, as well as the internet. Direct advertising campaigns will be of significant importance to the company, as the business is offering its services to a specific group of middle and higher income people. Timely coverage of the Milwaukee grounds and its race track facilities will be further directed through the ongoing press relations, news releases, and featured stories targeted at the key professional communities and the other media outlets. Publicity activities will be designed to generate ongoing coverage about the racetrack and targeted media by providing writers and editors with newsworthy releases, features, stories, briefs, and visual material for the columns and stories. So how do we plan to implement and fulfill our responsibilities related to the planning and implementation of the business? We've developed components which include responsible gambling, marketing, branding, and communication, horse improvement programs, animal welfare, and use performance metrics. After we have successfully opened Milwaukee County grounds, we will have a six-month evaluation where we will develop a plan to implement the performance metrics framework and an econometric model to monitor the Milwaukee's horse racing industry economic impact. Key aspects of the performance metric will include key performance indicators around customers and fans, as well as separate wagering and growth indicators. The econometric model will be implemented as the main tool to measure the return on public investment. In addition to the regulatory and industry program, measures will be developed to evaluate the effectiveness, efficiency, and client satisfaction of Milwaukee County grounds to assess the organization's ability to fulfill its new mandate. These measures and key performance indicators will be developed during the 2018 fiscal year.
Thank you for listening to us today. We really hope we convinced you to help us move forward in our plans of opening Milwaukee County grounds.
Thank you for your time.
In the end, we got the green light for Milwaukee County grounds. We know it's going to be a tough road, but we feel really optimistic about this opportunity. As long as we stick together, we can do anything, anything.
On,
pissing me off.
I did flip the phone in.
We definitely thought Michael.
You're going. Oh, you can cut it out on iMovie.
Stop recording.
As for our marketing promotion strategies.
So our first strength would be our fear. Come on, dude. You know what? Hello, my name is Mikiro. So our weaknesses. So like Aaron, by knowing this information, it's, we have a be faced with in the Milwaukee area. Now threats to sex ways. Segways. We're sorry, the horse track industry can drive. I'm moving on to my final presentation. Many new customers. New entertainment.